topped the 2016 Forbes list of the 100 highest paid celebs, but in 2017, Beyonce, Drake, The Weeknd, and Justin Bieber all battle it out for that top. Guys, it's Allie with your most necessary story of the day, and 2016 was a good year for T-Swift as she raked in an insane $170 million, mostly for her 1989 world tour. Taylor has obviously stepped away from the spotlight lately and fell from the top spot to number 49, making $44 million without really doing anything. Keep in mind, this list comes out at the half-year point, so let's take the rest of the riches from bottom to top. Taylor's nemesis, Katy Perry, came in at number 95, racking up $33 million. Kylie Jenner, as we told you, is number 59 with a whopping $41 million, though Kim, at 47, beat her sister, earning $45.5 million. Doing what exactly? I can't tell you. Taylor's ex, Calvin Harris, had an incredible year at number 40, earning $48.5 million, mostly from pushing play on his iTunes library. Falling just shy of the top 10, despite his wildly successful Purpose tour, Justin Bieber came in at number 13, earning $83.5 million. Considering the mansions he stays in at every tour stop, it's probably a good thing he's doing so well. Let's get to the top 10, though, and at number 10, King James is the highest paid American athlete, making $86 million. Selena Gomez's boyfriend did even better, though, making number 6, racking in $92 million in 2017 from his tour and the increased revenue coming from streaming services. In case you're wondering, Selena herself did not make the top 100. The highest paid athlete in the world is still Cristiano Ronaldo at number 5 with $93 million. The highest paid Canadian is Drake at number 4, earning a whopping $94 million. Big things indeed. Beyonce didn't crack the top 10 in 2016, but this year she's made number 2, earning $105 million. With husband Jay-Z also on the list at 55, earning $42 million, it's safe to say they had a good year. But okay, at number 1, it is Diddy himself. Yes, the man who laid down on the red carpet at the Met Gala raked in $130 million in the last year. He made the cash from selling one-third of his Sean John clothing line for $70 million, plus his Ciroc vodka, and then the Bad Boy Family Reunion Tour. No word on how much he made from those proactive ads, though.